Gorgeous rainbow.
Test, test, test. Thanks for stopping by. In today's video, we're going to talk about the Slammer 3 from Pin. Now, while I was reviewing this reel, Pin actually released the number 4 version of this reel, which when I went online to see what the key differences were, it looks like the number 4 has one extra bearing. It has a hydrophobic line roller bearing, which just simply means it's resistant to water. And then the styling on the front face of the handle knob is actually black as opposed to this brass color. Other than that, it virtually looks like the same reel. In this video, we're going to talk about body construction, bearing count, gear ratios, and drag system. We're also going to cover market analysis and my opinions, recommendations, and experiences using this reel. All right, without wasting any more time, let's get into it. Pin is not shy of metal, which is what I love about their reels. The Pin Slammer features a full metal body, side plate, and rotor, as well as CNC gear technology. The gear system is machined brass, which is a metal that falls under the corrosion proof category. Add on top of that, there is an outsized metal handle, which is big, comfortable, includes two bearings along with a seal. One might look upon other beautiful metal reels, such as a Fierce 3 or the legendary Spinfisher series, and scratch their heads as to why the Slammer comes in at an eye-watering $250 and above. At the end of the day, all you have to do is spend anywhere from $70 to $110 on a spinning reel and fish like an absolute pro. There are many options on the market from different manufacturers. To sum it all up in one sentence with respect to body construction, you're paying for corrosion prevention. In other words, you're paying for a network of seals that all work together to keep salt water from wrecking havoc on your reel's internals. Pin has coined this system the Ingress Protection Rating x6, or IPX6 for short. You will only see this on their higher end reels such as the Pin Torque and the Spinfisher 6, which actually has the IPX5. Now, IPX6 and IPX5 are more of a rating system for the level of sealing that a reel incorporates. Out of the box, the Slammer comes with 14 seals. 13 seals are used to operate the reel, and the extra seal is incorporated with the spare handle that comes with the box. If we take a look at the Spinfisher's IPX5, that system incorporates just 8 seals. The schematic listed O-rings, but they are seals nonetheless. If we move further down the food chain, you might notice that the Mighty Pin Fierce 3 only incorporates exactly 0 seals. So for body construction, you're primarily paying for seals. Now with those 13 seals comes a lot more infrastructure to accommodate them. This equals more parts, more machining, more labor, and a lot more money. Not to mention the improved quality and materials used. Just look at how much more complicated the Slammer schematic is compared to the Fierce 3 and the Spinfisher 6. It's night and day. All right, I think we've covered seals quite enough. Let's pivot to wear and tear. I've used this reel very heavily. You can see on the bail holder that I'm starting to lose some paint. This is probably from setting the reel down on rock, driving around with it in the bed of my truck, and letting my friends borrow it. The wear and tear is perfectly normal, and actually it's holding up very well for the amount of abuse I've put it through. This is an exceptionally well-built reel in terms of body construction. Let's move on to bearing counts. Fishing reel manufacturers utilize ball bearings to smooth out the operation of their reels. In general, the more ball bearings a reel contains, the less friction it will have between the moving parts. This makes a reel operate more smoothly as the bearing count increases. Not all bearings are created equal, however. Some are open and poorly made, while some are sealed and built with exacting precision. With this in mind, it's important to remember that quality is much more important than quantity when it comes to ball bearings and reels. The sealed bearings used in pin reels are of excellent quality, and they are stainless steel, so you have yet another layer of corrosion prevention. The Slammer utilizes 7 plus 1 bearings. In other words, you have 7 ball bearings and 1 roller bearing, which serves as the anti-reverse clutch. If we look at the schematic, we can see 2 ball bearings located on the pinion gear. We can see that 2 are located on the drive gear. An additional 2 are located in the knob assembly, which I might add is twice the amount of bearings that are located within my $200 Pin 704 Zulu reel, which is a new construction version of a very old reel. Finally, 1 bearing is located under the line roller, and the final plus 1 or roller clutch is located on the pinion gear. All right, not to measure bearing counts, but if we take a look at a competing Shimano Saragossa, it has a bearing count of 5 plus 1. So I would say the 7 plus 1 in the Pin Slammer 3 is more than enough. And like I mentioned earlier, the new Slammer 4 will have 8 plus 1. Don't get wrapped around bearing counts. The Slammer has 8 to 9 depending on what generation you get. That's more than you'll ever need. It's ready to rock and roll. Let's move on to the next topic. I would argue that gear ratios are not cost prohibitive for reel manufacturers. This is probably why an $80 Pin Fierce 3 has the same exact gear ratio as a $250 plus Pin Slammer. Both reels have a 6.2 to 1 gear ratio. Now if we look at a comparable Shimano Saragossa, it also has the same ratio. Basically what this ratio means is that for every turn of your handle, the spool will rotate 6.2 times. This will give you about a 40 inch recovery rate. This is right in line with industry standards. The Cast King Speed Demon Elite has a 7.4 to 1 gear ratio and a 42 inch recovery. However, at $99, I'm sure the build quality is nowhere near comparable to the Slammer or Shimano Saragossa. If it is, it would be the deal of the century. Now, let me tell you a quick story about the last time I went fishing out on the ocean pier. When I was out there, some gangster was out there using a 4500 Slammer 3 to haul in a 6-foot shark. He had 65 pound braid with a 100 pound monofilament leader. The reel had no problems whatsoever. I tell this story because I want to highlight that the Slammer is built for all out war in any saltwater scenario. My 4500 series Slammer is rated up to 30 pounds of drag, which is awesome. The DuraDrag system on the Slammer is carbon fiber with a special coating applied to it that binds the fibers together and makes them waterproof. This greatly enhances durability while creating one of the smoothest drag systems I've ever experience. Smooth startups and consistent pressures prevent pulled hooks and line failures. On my cheaper reels, the drag systems can be a little bit clumsy. It takes a lot of pressure to get them going, or they respond very sluggishly, and that can cause problems. Now, when it comes to the DuraDrag system used in the Slammer, Pin states that the washers are based off of materials used in the transmissions of racing cars. I'm not joking when I say this is probably the best drag system you'll ever experience, because you pretty much have a race car transmission built into your reel. Now, most other Pins use the proprietary HT100 system, which stands for High Tech 100 Miles, which means the drag system is good up to 100 miles of line pull without experiencing major washer wear and tear. You'll love it. Let's do some good old-fashioned market analysis. Some solid market competitors for the Pin Slammer would be the Shimano Saragossa and the Quantum Cabo. These reels are both north of $200 and built for the serious saltwater angler. The Shimano Saragossa starts around $260, has about 22 pounds of drag, a 40 inch recovery, an IPX8 waterproof body, and carbon drag washers. It is a purpose-built saltwater machine, just like the Slammer. Coming in at around $220, the Quantum Cabo has 30 to 35 pounds of drag, which is impressive, a 5.3 to 1 gear ratio with a recovery rate between 33 to 35 inches, so it's a little bit lower on the recovery rate, and 7 plus 1 bearings and saltwater corrosion mitigation. So it's like a toned down Saragossa and a toned down Slammer. All in all, compared to serious competitors, I'd say the Slammer is right where it needs to be, if not the leader. I fully admit that the price tag is high, but this reel will last a lifetime despite experiencing heavy exposure to saltwater. Between just the body seals and drag system alone, this reel is worth every penny. And that's really all I gotta say about the Pin Slammer. As always, thanks for stopping by, and make sure you get out and go fish. We'll see you later.